Before getting into this video, if you have not watched the previous video in this application series, which is the overview of the medical school application timeline, please watch that before this one so you have more context on why you should take the MCAT at a certain time. In this video, we're going to be talking about when is ideal to take your MCAT. I am a traditional applicant. I took one gap year, and so I was applying for medical school during my gap year. I took my MCAT the September, the year before my application cycle opened. So this is the September of my senior year. I took the MCAT and then I applied in the May after my senior year had ended. If you're someone like me and you know that you cannot study during the school year while you have to balance 5 courses, then I would recommend taking your MCAT in September after your summer break or in January after your winter break. My advice kind of differs if you're planning on applying straight into medical school, so you're going to be applying in your senior year while you're still in college. I think in that situation, more people tend to take the MCAT in the spring. If you're applying straight in, given the advice that I just gave you, you would be taking the MCAT after the summer, after your sophomore year. And so this can be really early, especially if you haven't finished your prereqs. So in that situation, some people might want to take it later, like again, after winter break or in the spring, just so you have more time to finish up your prerequisites before taking the MCAT. Some people also take biochemistry that fall so that in the spring, they'll have that fresh in their mind and they can take the MCAT. So given this information, if you want to still take your MCAT after a summer break, plan your prerequisites so that you are done with the major core prerequisites in your first 2 years. This can be a lot more of a rush timeline than for people who are planning to take a gap year. So it's probable that you're going to have to double or even triple up on your pre-med prerequisites in your first 2 years.
For non-traditional applicants who have to balance a job and other responsibilities, you might have to spread out your studying a little bit more than a traditional applicant. If you can, I would try to get the last few weeks of studying right before your test date either off or working remotely or part-time. I know this is hard though, but I think towards the end of your studying, you definitely have to ramp up a little bit.
Another question you might have is, when is too late to take the MCAT? If you can avoid it, I would not take your MCAT too late in the spring, like in April or May. Because it takes 4 weeks to get your score after taking the MCAT, I would say therefore that the latest I recommend taking the MCAT would be in April so that you could have a retake in May if absolutely necessary. I still would follow that earlier advice of taking it after a break. So again, around September or January, I think those are probably the more ideal test dates so that you can push it back to the spring if you absolutely have to. Some other important things to consider when you're scheduling your MCAT test date is, are you prepared? Have you taken the necessary prerequisites? In terms of the prerequisites that I think you definitely need to take before taking the MCAT, I would say your biology, general chemistry, biochemistry, Orgo 1, I think that's really hard to self-study. Some people are able to self-study physics, so that would be kinematics and electricity and magnetism. I would recommend taking at least kinematics, so physics 1 before your MCAT. I would say optional courses that are helpful would be physiology, microbiology kind of. Genetics is really helpful to take, but I didn't before the MCAT. I would say you don't need a psychology or sociology course before taking the MCAT. I think that usually is easier for people to self-study. Assess your preparation based off of your own strengths and weaknesses. For instance, if you did AP Physics in high school, you might not need to take Physics 1 and 2 before your MCAT. Another thing to keep in mind is that the MCAT expires after usually 3 years. Check with your dream schools how long they accept the MCAT for. But this is important to consider if, for instance, you're taking the MCAT 2 years in advance, you should be good for one reapplication cycle for most schools. However, if you're someone who's very risk averse and you want to assure that you will be able to have a reapplication cycle and not have to retake the MCAT, I would say don't take your MCAT earlier than 1 year in advance of your application cycle. So this would be like what I did, taking it the September a year before. Take this advice with a grain of salt though. This depends on what schools you're applying to, how risk averse you are. I'm very risk averse. All right, so to summarize the main points of this video, I would recommend taking your MCAT after a major break. So that would be after summer break or after winter break, so you have some time for dedicated studying. An exception might be if you're applying straight through, you might want to take it in the spring if you have some prerequisites to catch up on. So if you're taking it in the spring, that would be a few weeks before your application cycle opens. Regardless of when your MCAT test date is, try to factor in some buffer time if you need to retake or if anything comes up. And finally, if you're thinking about taking more gap years, or if you think you might have a possibility of reapplying, consider the schools you're applying to and how old of an MCAT they will take. All right, I know it was super confusing for me when I was deciding when to take the MCAT, so I hope this video was helpful. If you still have questions, leave a comment down below and I will make sure to reply. All right, take care and I'll see you in the next video.